Yeah, they're going to talk to you and talk to you and talk to you about individual freedom. But they see a free individual, it's going to scare them.
Yeah, well, don't make them running scared.
No, it makes them dangerous.
With Keith Ball, the editor of Easy Riders magazine. He took me to San Diego to get this tattoo on my arm. I wanted a rose, but he goes, no to the tattoo artist. So I just did what they said. It is long since faded. This one did not fade. It's fairly current. On the way down, he drove a Mustang. He drove by Bob Dylan's house and pointed out, there's Bob Dylan's house. And his tires on his car were just worn thin. I was scared to ride with him. That's when I was very young. A sailor suit was probably given to me by Uncle Clarence, an ex-Navy man. He used to take me to the bars and he'd drink his Pabst Blue Ribbon, the same kind of beer I drink today. For every beer he'd drink, it only cost a quarter a glass, he'd buy me a bottle of grape knee-high. I was afloat in pop. My mom took care of me a lot, took a lot of abuse from my dad. My dad and my sister and myself when I still look cute. My sister, Michaela, she saved me from going to reformatory way, way back when. God bless her. My dad, my grandpa, they were adversaries. They'd get in arguments constantly, and I had to get between them, and they'd say, well, who's right, who's right? And it put me in a hell of a situation. Maybe it taught me to be a peacekeeper, I guess. Della, she used to make me dough cookie. Wouldn't cook, she'd make dough, but not cook it. I'd eat it raw, sugar cookie stuff. She used to work at Jake's Cafe, and I was with her when she died. She died very painfully. My Grandpa Rudy, I could do no wrong in his eyes. He gave me my first car, a 49 Chevy, which I appropriately wrecked on a telephone pole, and destroyed city property with the car, and he always helped me fix things up. And I love the man. That's where I grew up. That's where I learned mechanics. Iwanski's garage. And in the back left picture, you see that small window. That was my bedroom. And I'd look out the window at night and see Keating's mortuary sign and look at it before I went to sleep. And that is Uncle Clarence. He did appear in a dream to me at the end of my bed. It was like a silhouette. I could see him, but you could see through him. And he told me to be a good boy. And I don't think I followed his advice. I was an altar boy for Father Flaglursky, the cigar smoker. I did have an enjoyable time serving Mass. I didn't know what was going on because I spoke in Latin. And one day, old father had a big old dog with long hair, and he smoked cigars like crazy, and the dog stunk like cigar smoke. And he walked into the altar once while Mass was going on, and I got up and I tried to get him off the mat from Mass to go back in the sanctuary, and he bit me, and I still have the scar on my hand from that. But all in all, I enjoyed it. I didn't understand what was going on, but I did get $2 a week, a lot of money for a kid. My favorite nun, Sister Maxine, is the mean-looking one. She was a horrible teacher. By that time, I was in the eighth grade. And when I was in the eighth grade, I didn't know it, but I was dyslexic. And so they'd send me back to the second grade. That'd be the nun on the far left. And she'd feel sorry for me. Sister Christopher was her name. And to make me sit in little chairs just demeaned the hell out of me. Later on, after I was expelled from school, I went down to Chet's Drive in St. Paul, Chet Dinsdale, and I was playing the pinball machine. And her and the two other nuns came in, and she saw me, and she says, looked at me straight in the eye and said, "You are going to burn in hell." One of the last days I even considered going to church was one Sunday afternoon. I remember Sister Maxine, her voice echoed me, "You're going to go to hell. You're going to go to hell if you don't go to church." I walked in the side door. I was about 12, and I seen the big bell rope. That's like 2-3 inches thick, and I touched it with my hands. I could feel it in my hands. I said, "Man, I want to pull the damn thing." Then I says, "I'm not going in. I'll take my chances and burn in hell if I have to." Last time I ever went to church. Carl, my favorite cop. Him and I were enemies. He tortured me, I tortured him. One time he caught me doing something or another, and he tried to put me in jail. He tried to put me in cuffs. And I said, "You ain't never gonna do that." So he started beating me on the face with his fist. And then I said, "Hell, I'm getting in that cell." And as I pulled, he was trying to pull me in, but he had his hand on the edge of the door, and I slammed it tight in his hand. He really got pissed. He let me out a few hours later because he knew he'd done wrong. And I went home. My dad saw that, and he says, my dad said, I'm gonna go get that guy. I'm gonna kick shit out of him. And I said, "No, Dad, I kind of tortured Carl myself." Carly liked me a whole lot after I painted his name on the St. Paul Water Tower. Dick Ears and I did it.
"Oh yeah, they're gonna talk to you and talk to you and talk to you about individual freedom. But they see a free individual, it's gonna scare them."
"No, well, don't make them running scared."
"No, it makes them dangerous."
With the wind and the feeling that I'm